everything you're going through is preparing you for what you ask God for. You just got to quit tripping while you're in the process, because the process is necessary. You may not see it now, but when he gets you on the other side of it, you're going to see exactly why it went that way. And you're going to be okay with it. But quit tripping during the process. Oh, Lord, why me? You ain't the only one. Oh, Lord, why me? You ain't the only one. Oh, Lord, why I lose my job? You ain't the only one unemployed. Oh, Lord, why he leave me? You ain't the first chick got left. This might not even be your last time getting left. Pull yourself together and quit tripping because you in the process. God is processing you. He ain't through with you. If he was through with you, you would not wake up in the morning. He gonna fix it. Everything is wrong. First of all, let me tell you this right here. Why are you tripping? I look back on my life at all that I've been through. So the stuff I'm currently going through, I have built up enough reservoir that living in the car taught me that this ain't it. So the things I'm going through now, I know this ain't it. And he gonna come get me in a minute. So all I gotta do is sit tight. I ain't in a bad place. Now, I ain't where I wanna be, but the spot I'm in is better than where I was. I ain't homeless. So what I'm going through right now, y'all don't know, I got some challenges. Don't you, people think when you get famous or rich that your problems is over. Oh, they got a whole new set of them for you. They got some stuff you ain't seen. Biggie wrote a song, said one time, more money, more problems. I gotta tell you something, that boy would never lie. But I'll tell you the truth right now. The problems I got right now, I take them. Because the problems I had when I was homeless, I don't want them no more. See, money going to change your life a little bit, folks. All of you going to get more. But you got to ask for it. It's like this young lady said, I said, you have not because you ask not. Listen to me. The Bible says you have not because you ask not. It didn't say you have not because you don't make enough. It didn't say you have not because your credit ain't straight. It simply say you have not because you ask not. But you don't ask because you ain't got that together. When you ask God for something, quit tripping. He got it from here. Well, Lord, if I could just stay with him a little bit longer, maybe you don't need him. Maybe he the reason you ain't got nothing now. Well, I don't want to leave him because I've been with him 8 years. Well, hold up. Whoa. You want 8 more years of this? Let his monkey ass go. But now, God can't give you what you want because you want to hold on to what you got. You all in the way. Now you telling him how to bless you. You can't tell God how to bless you. It's a simple process. The only reason I'm telling you this, because this is how I made it. I just do me. I'm just being me. I stay uniquely who I am because you are okay just the way you are, because God made you uniquely who you are. He wanted you to be just like you are. I mean, really, man, if you look at life and just step outside for a minute and quit tripping, it really ain't no problem. That God I serve that done this for me, he'll do the same thing for you. Listen to me, man. You have a great life in front of you. But your great life is in front of you. It's not behind you. What you did back there ain't got nothing to do with what God got for you. What you did back there was learn the lessons to get you to where you are at this particular moment right here. But what God got for you, do you know, man, that you can actually mess your life completely up? You can jack it all the way up and you can turn around and get it right. Do you understand that? Do you understand that you could have had a baby out of wedlock and still be all right? Do you know that you can be divorced multiple times and still be okay? Do you understand that you cannot have a degree and still be just fine? You want to know how I know? Because I'm telling you what I know. I lost everything twice. I don't know if you've ever lost everything before, but I've been bottomed out twice. I done seen rock bottom 2 times. I've been through some walls up in here, man. I'm just trying to tell you, man, God is really with you. You ain't got to believe me. You ain't got to believe me. But keep doing it without God. Let me know how it worked for you. Matter of fact, write a book on how to make it without God. Because I want to read it. I want to read the first page. And then I want to read the last page because there ain't going to be but two. You can jack your life all the way up. God is in the forgiving business. You can make all the mistakes you want to make or think you shouldn't make. God is in the get it together business. If you got dreams and visions, I got news for you. God is in the make your dream come true business. He did it for me. How he won't do it for you? A lot of y'all better than me. I'm just going to flat out tell you. Most of y'all ain't done what I had to do to get to where I am today. You just ain't had to do this type of dirt. You ain't been homeless, so you ain't got the scrap like me. Most of y'all didn't come. You're not old as me. I've overcome it all because I have a relationship with him. And you can listen to me and tell that I'm not a perfect person. I am not a perfect Christian. I have my flaws. I am a flawed human being. But guess what? You are too. You ain't got it all together. I dare you to say you do. I make a lot of money, man. But guess what? I ain't got it all together. I'm hurting, man. Everybody tripping through something. Everybody, I don't care who you are, you going through something. But if you got God, you can make it. I'm just telling you this little piece of information. I don't see most of y'all most of the time. So you're sitting here, you're kind of looking at me a little bit odd. Why Steve talking like this stuff? I'm just trying to put you on game. Because let me tell you, all y'all want to be successful. And you want to be happy, but you got to get there. It's a shortcut to getting there. The shortcut to getting there is the relationship with God. If you try it without him, you're going to fail miserably. You're going to sink, man. It's going to be ugly for you. Now, this is what you got to do. Identify your gift and get busy with it. God gave all of you a gift. Identify your gift. It is the thing that you do the absolute best with the least amount of effort. That's your gift. Get busy at that. If it's drawing, if it's teaching, if it's sharing, if it's caregiving, he put that gift inside of you. He didn't hide it under a rock or put it under the mountain or put it on the mountain somewhere. He put the gift in you. And you look at me any kind of way you want to, what I'm just telling you is real. That's how you become successful. Identify your God-given gift, what he gave you at birth. If you do that, God will open up the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing that you won't have room enough to receive. I am telling you, that is a fact.